in this video, we are going to learn how to write cursive capital letters beautifully and correctly. The reason why we prefer cursive handwriting over block letters is that when we write in cursive hand, we don't have to pick our pencil again and again. As a result, our writing speed increases. For beginning purpose, we will be using a notebook with 4 lines and a gap type ruling. Here we have 4 lines, 1, 2, 3 and 4, followed by a gap. All the capital cursive letters will be formed in either 3 lines or 4 lines. Now, let's begin. First we'll need capital cursive A. This is what capital cursive A looks like. In order to make capital cursive A, we begin somewhere in between the second and the third line. Make a curve like this. Go back to the first line, come down again, and then we make an oval curve like this. This is capital cursive A. Let me make it once again for you. Capital cursive A. In order to make capital cursive B, we begin from the first line. Go to the third line, come back again, make a small curve like this, then a big curve. B has another variant where you have a slightly different ending. You can end it like this, bend it a little inward. Both of them are correct, you can make any one of them you want. Capital cursive B. Some people make capital cursive C as follows. It looks quite similar to L and hence one might get confused. Therefore, I would suggest you to make capital cursive C like this. It looks quite similar to small cursive C. Small cursive C is made in 2 lines, whereas capital cursive C is made in 3 lines. 1, 2 and 3. Now we'll make capital cursive D. We'll start from first line, go down and make a curve like this and followed by a bigger curve like this. This is capital cursive D. Let me make it once again for you. Capital cursive D. Let's repeat it once more. Capital cursive D. In order to make capital cursive E, we'll start from second line. Make a knot like this and followed by a curve which ends like this. This is capital cursive E. You can make another variant of capital cursive E without this knot in the end. Both are correct. You can make any one of them, but I would suggest you to make the first one. It looks good. Now we'll make capital cursive F. It looks quite similar to capital cursive T, which we will see in future. In order to begin, we'll start somewhere in between the first and the second line. And then we move to the first line, make a wavy line like this, come down, and then we'll put a dash in the middle. This is capital cursive F. Once more, this is capital cursive F. Capital cursive F. Now we'll make capital cursive G. It is the first letter from the beginning which is made in all 4 lines. Let me show you how to make it. We'll begin from third line, go up like this, come back down again, then move to the second line, go to the fourth line and make a curve like this. This is capital cursive G. Let's make it once again. Capital cursive G. One more time. Capital cursive G. Now we'll write capital cursive H. It is one of the letters for which we need to lift our pen at least once. We'll begin from second line, go to the first line, then make a straight line with a curve, and then at certain distance we'll make another straight line and join both of them using an oval curve like this. Let me make it once more for you. While making capital cursive H, always make sure that this oval curve we are making always lies below the second line. Now we'll make capital cursive I. It is one of the simplest letter to make. We'll begin from second line, go up to the first line with a curve and then make a straight line with a curve. This is capital cursive I. Now we'll make capital cursive J. It is made in four lines and it is quite similar to capital cursive I. Unlike capital cursive I, we don't stop at the third line. We go to the fourth line like this and end it with a knot. This is capital cursive J. Now we'll make capital cursive K, which looks quite similar to print capital K. The only difference between the two is it is little curvy and it is little slanted or tilted. Let's make capital cursive K once again. And one more time, capital cursive K. Now we'll make capital cursive L. We'll begin from second line, make a knot like this, come back again to the third line with a straight line, and another knot and wavy line. Capital cursive L. One more time, capital cursive L. It is very simple to make once you do the practice. Now we'll make capital cursive M. There are two variants of capital cursive M. In first one, this middle part lies on the third line. Now we'll make the second variant in which the middle part lies on the second line only. Both of them are correct. However, I would suggest you to make the first one because it looks beautiful. Now we'll make capital cursive N. It is very simple to make. Capital cursive N. Both capital cursive M and capital cursive N looks quite similar to print capital M and print capital N respectively. The only difference once again is that we make it little curvy and slanted or tilted. Capital cursive O, which is quite similar to small cursive O. The only difference between both of them is that small cursive O is made in two lines, whereas capital cursive O is made in three lines. We'll make capital cursive O once again. And one more time, capital cursive O. Now we'll make capital cursive P, which is exactly similar to capital cursive B, but the only difference is there is just one upper curve in it. We don't make the lower curve just like we make it in B. Capital cursive P. We'll make capital cursive Q, which is quite similar to block capital Q. Let me make it for you. This is block capital Q. The only difference is that in capital cursive Q, we extend this oval a little and make it come inward. Capital cursive Q. Now we'll make capital cursive R, which is basically P with a slanted line. This is capital cursive R. One more time, capital cursive R. And once again, capital cursive R. Now we'll make capital cursive S. We begin from the third line, go up, make a knot like this, and then slide down back with a curve and move inward. It is exactly similar to small cursive S. Once again, capital cursive S. Make sure that this upper knot lies between the first and the second line only and should not come out. Once again, capital cursive S. Capital cursive T, which is exactly similar to capital cursive F but without a dash in the middle. Remember, we have told you this thing while making capital cursive F that if we don't put a dash, it will look like T. This is capital cursive T, exactly similar. Capital cursive U. For making capital cursive U, we begin from third line, go up to the first line, make a curve like this, and this is capital cursive U. Now we'll learn to make capital cursive V. We can make capital cursive V by starting from somewhere in between first and second line. There is another variant where we start right away from second line and make V. You can make any one of the two which makes you feel comfortable. Now we'll make capital cursive W, which is made in two variants. The first one is this, where the middle part touches the first line. This is the second variant of capital cursive W. You can make either of the two, but I would personally suggest you to make the first one because it is easy to make and it looks good. Now we'll make capital cursive X, which is exactly similar to small cursive X. We can start from second line. We can also make it without lifting the pen like this, but it is little difficult. Therefore, I would suggest you to make it with lifting the pen. Now we'll make capital cursive Y, which is exactly similar to small cursive Y, but it is made in four lines. This is small cursive Y. It is made in three lines, whereas capital one is made in four lines. Capital cursive Y. One more time. Capital cursive Y. Now we'll make capital cursive Z. It is little different from all the other alphabets. In other alphabets, all the curves and all the lines lie between two lines or three lines, but here it comes little outside the two lines like this. Let me make it for you once again. This is capital cursive Z. Again, capital cursive Z. With this, we come to the end of this video. If you like the content, press the like button. To get regular updates from this channel, hit the subscribe button. You can leave your feedback in the comment section below. Thank you.